cosmic horror is tied to the imagination of H.P. Lovecraft, everyone's favorite horror author over here at Top 5 Scary. It is defined simply as the fundamental premise that common human laws and interests and emotions have no validity or significance in the vast cosmos at large. However, people, Lovecraftian horror and cosmic horror are not the same thing. That being said, cosmic horror fundamentally involves a terror predicted on the dislocation and dwarfing of human sense and understanding. Simply put, it is a horror beyond comprehension, something you just can't quite understand. Now, Jack covered part 1 and 2 of this list, but I've taken over the responsibility, and hopefully I can do it some justice. Bear with me. So today on Top 5 Scary Videos, I'm going to be counting down our list of the Top 5 Scariest Cosmic Horror Movies Part 3. Before we begin though, be sure to stick around until the end of the video where I'll be responding to some of your comments. And with that, let's jump in.
Danny?
Coming in at 5, Pandorum. Released in 2009 and directed by Christian Alvart, Pandorum centers on two astronauts that wake up in what seems like a pitch black spacecraft. Disoriented and unable to remember who they are or what their mission was, they quickly discover they are not alone. Now, solely based on aesthetics, Event Horizon and Pandorum have a lot in common. And a quick fact for you folks out there, the word Pandorum actually refers to what happens to the human psyche as a result of deep space hibernation. It is characterized by feeling of abandonment and hopelessness alongside dementia symptoms. Now, the movie literally begins with two flight crew members waking up from hibernation on board the Elysium, only to discover it's abandoned and experiencing power fluctuations. They explore and discover some crew members alive and sane, alongside cannibalistic humanoid creatures that are hunting them down. Now, this particular film does have many ties to Lovecraftian horror, because the madness does not come from the creatures themselves, but the humans who are pushed to insanity. Coming in at number 4 is Maki. Released in 2000 and directed by Higuchinsky, the movie centers on Kiri and Shuichi, who are friends in a small town who begin to notice that Shuichi's father, Toshio, has become utterly obsessed with snails, videotaping them in his garden and gathering items that resemble the spiral patterns on their shells. Kiri begins to see spirals elsewhere too, even in the way people dress and comport their bodies. The movie is of course based on the manga of the same name and is an overlooked gem that sadly didn't gain the recognition it deserved during the horror boom of the late 90s and early 2000s. This is well and truly a nightmare movie, with a small town literally being turned into spiral-shaped creatures. Can you imagine that? The terror that unfolds is otherworldly, but at the same time confirms our theories that there is more going on in the universe than we know. Even better, the film never tells us why these strange occurrences are happening. Just that one day, we're living our lives, and the next, we're snails. You never know when it might happen. Honestly, this film is beautiful and daring and just downright terrifying. So, if you haven't checked it out yet, do it now. Coming in at number 3, Absentia. As we know, not all cosmic horror has to be centered around outer space, with Absentia specifically bringing the horror down to Earth. Released in 2011 and directed by everyone's new favorite director, Mike Flanagan of Haunting of Hill House fame, Absentia centers on a woman and her sister who begin to link a mysterious tunnel to a series of disappearances, including that of her own husband. Trisha is a woman in California whose husband has been missing for 7 years, and as she's preparing to declare him dead, her sister arrives with new information. Information about a strange tunnel near their home. The film is in the same creative vein as Don't Be Afraid of the Dark and Pan's Labyrinth, with the two characters being drawn into the influence of a strange supernatural world, referred to as underground, by people who have been there. Now, what makes this movie so effective is the simple fact that the creatures in the movie are so rarely seen, as is the underground itself, with the film focusing more on character development than flashy effects. You never quite get a good look at the monsters, they are always just at the edge of your vision. And although you see very little, the film is still incredibly effective and successfully plays with the audience's imagination. Definitely check it out. Coming in at number 2, Pulse. No film in the horror genre has successfully captured the concept of loneliness, quite like Kiyoshi Kurosawa's Pulse. The plot centers on ghosts invading the world of the living via the internet and features two parallel storylines. Now, the movie movie gives new meaning to the word haunting, as it manages to show us a world where even the undead dread the feeling of loneliness and being alone in the universe. The movie is existential horror at its finest, with ghosts desperately trying to force their way back into the world of the living, whereas the living are committing suicide, and the world is crumbling beneath the misery we call existence. The film is in equal parts terrifying and also an interesting insight into our feelings about the world and our existence within it. Plus, no fear is as great as the fear of not feeling anything at all. The film received rave reviews upon release, with the New York Times stating, "There are very few moments in Kiyoshi Kurosawa's fiercely original, thrillingly creepy horror movie that doesn't evoke a dreamlike dread of the truly unknown." And honestly, no truer words have been spoken. This film should be feasted upon, and if you haven't checked it out yet, go do it now. And finally coming in at number 1, Sunshine. Directed by the legendary Danny Boyle and released in 2007, Sunshine centers on a team of astronauts who are assigned the huge responsibility of saving the sun. That's right, the entire sun. However, things take an ugly turn when an accident occurs and the lives of the crew members are endangered. Now, the movie itself is a drama horror, and during the deep space mission, the group of specialists must attempt to restoke the dying sun by triggering another nuclear reaction via a massive atom bomb. In the universe of the film, this mission has been undertaken once before, but failed. Thus, every decision the crew members are forced to make invokes a sense of pressure, an entirely real pressure. Now, during this, there are external forces at play that are working to sabotage the important mission, cosmic creatures. However, we don't see them, not at first. Instead, the movie relies on psychological tactics, making it feel like the crew are being driven to the point of madness. Well, there we have it. Do you guys agree with that list? Were there any cosmic horror movies that we missed? Leave us all your thoughts and feelings in the comments down below, and perhaps we can do a part 4. Before I go though, I just want to respond to a few comments from one of our last videos. Top 5 scary cryptids you need to read about, part 2. This is one of those days I wish I scripted the answers. Adam Jenk said, "Lucy's wearing the fluffy hat again. This is gonna be great. And oh yeah, cryptids are real." I don't know what it is about that fluffy hat, but you've all got strong feelings. Good feelings about the hat, but weird feelings about the hat. It's just a hat. That's all it is. Alan Lindley said, "The question is Lucy a cryptid? Then again, she's one of the cutest cryptids I've ever seen. Just wondering, Lucy, are you married or dating? Lol." Yes, I am a cryptid. I know I'm incredibly cute. I'm not telling you anything. I'm both married, dating, widowed, divorced, single. I'm all of the things. Username I can't pronounce said, "I'm intrigued by the hat. I need to know the story." Honestly, there's no story about my hat. It is just a hat. I got it from H&M. And I wear it on cold days. And sometimes when I wear it, I get hat hair. And then when I have hat hair, I can't remove the hat when filming because you'll see how bad my hair looks. That's the story behind the hat and why I wear it in videos. There we go. Anthony Long said, "Where do I sign to become a McFiend?" Anthony, have you not been watching the videos? It's not McFiend anymore, it's the Lucifers. And you sign below to join the Lucifers. Like, comment, subscribe. That's how you join. And on that note, if you haven't already, be sure to give this video a big thumbs up, subscribe, and turn on notifications so you never miss another scary vid. And until next time, see you later.